Did you know?
History books are lying. History books are lying.
And
Africa is not our home. Oh, while I dig for fat. Africa is not our home.
Because
the Indians were you. The Indians were you.
The Indians were you.
That's why.
Finds himself in exile in his own land. His own land.
So
you just want to claim a spot? For the whole thing.
Because
we were always here. We were always here. We were always here. We were always here.
Welcome to the Aboriginal Channel. This episode will be part two to paper genocide in Kentucky. Here we have Wikipedia open to an explanation of the Homestead Acts. Says the Homestead Acts were several laws in the United States by which an applicant could acquire ownership of government land or the public domain, typically called a homestead. In all, more than 160 million acres of public land, or nearly 10% of the total area of the United States, was given away free to 1.6 million homesteaders. Most of the homesteads were west of the Mississippi River. An extension of the homestead principle in law, the Homestead Acts were an expression of the free soil policy of Northerners who wanted individual farmers to own and operate their own farms, as opposed to Southern slave owners who wanted to buy up large tracts of land and use slave labor, thereby shutting out free white farmers. The first of the acts, the Homestead Act of 1862, opened up millions of acres. Any adult who had never taken up arms against the federal government of the United States could apply. Women and immigrants who had applied for citizenship were eligible. The 1866 Act explicitly included Black Americans and encouraged them to participate, but rampant discrimination, systematic barriers, and bureaucratic inertia slowed Black gains. Several additional laws were enacted in the latter half of the 19th century, that's the 1800s, and early 20th century, right after the Dawes Rolls closed. The Southern Homestead Act of 1866 sought to address land ownership inequalities in the South during Reconstruction. The Timber Culture Act of 1873 granted land to a claimant who was required to plant trees. The tract could be added to any existing home claim and have no residency requirement. The Kincaid Amendment of 1904 granted a full section, 640 acres, to new homesteaders settling in western Nebraska. And an amendment to the Homestead Act of 1862, the Enlargement Homestead Act, was passed in 1909 and doubled the allotment acreage from 160 to 320 acres in marginal areas. Another amended act, the National Stock Raising Homestead Act, was passed in 1916 and granted 640 acres for ranching purposes. Pause. So all of these dates, the Homestead Act of 1862 and the 1866 Act, those dates align with the so many destroyed courthouses and destroyed records. Particularly, we're going to focus this on Kentucky. So we see that Abraham Lincoln was going around taking Indians' land and then passing an act or a law to give it to new settlers from Europe. Here we have Kentucky's population by race. So we're going to look at, in 1860, there was 919,000 whites and 236,000 blacks. You go up to 1870, now in between 1860 and 1870, you had a lot of wars. There would not have been a lot of immigrants from Europe coming during those years, based upon all the wars that lasted going into the 1900s, but were very condensed in the 1860s. So in 1870, the population in Kentucky for the whites was 1 million, and for blacks it was 222,000. Okay, so from 1870 to 1880, the white population went up about 300,000 in Kentucky, while the black population only went up 49,000. That indicates what we've seen in the destroyed courthouses and records during the Civil War. Then the Homestead Act of 1866, which brought all these 300,000 more white immigrants to Kentucky. Now let's look at from 1880 to 1890, when we read in an article where they were going around unearthing mummified giants and things of that nature, which indicates when they were actually getting here to America. So from 1880 to 1890, the white population in Kentucky went up a little over 200,000, while the black population in Kentucky decreased by 3,000. So we're seeing right here in the numbers how this whole thing went.
Through the history books, which has all been a lie, so therefore, if it's a lie, then what's the truth? If it's a lie, then what's the truth?